Hey everybody, it's the Poltergeist 1000 back from more Earthbound. In the last episode, we made it through the pyramid and we found Dungeon Man. And in this episode, we're going to go through Dungeon Man. It is an obligation to hire a doctor and a nurse. Brick Road. Well, isn't that just nice? You can't change the suspicions of checking into a hotel. Except you can't fix stuff. So it's not actually like checking into a hotel at all. Boy, you even got a guy down there. No, I don't need you to explain the hospital system. Jeez. It'd be nice if the nurses actually had, like, okay. Man, so many mans. Scalding coffee cup. Yeah, this is weird. A lot of the enemies you encounter in here are actually rehashes of enemies from... Oh my gosh, those guys are just as dangerous as ever. Okay, definitely kill them first. Yeah, a lot of these enemies are rehashes from enemies you fought earlier in the game, like, the Foresight Department Store, the Brick Road Dungeon in Winters, and Moonside, oddly enough. But, yeah. It's so this area really isn't that dangerous. The pretty much the most damage you'll ever take is from those guys. I think you can run into, like, some enemies from the new Winters. Like, you can run into, dudes. The lesser mooks. I think you can run into them in here. Maybe the hyper-spinning robos. What's the other one? Woolly Shambler? Yeah. What do you say? Keep this board in mind. Brick Road. Now, I kind of have to hurry it up here, because I got fries in the oven at 450 degrees, so that shit's gonna burn if I don't get up there in, like, half an hour. Even though you can't get up there now, you might be able to later. Brick Road. That's true. Absolutely true. First goal is to reach the four ropes. Brick Road. Thank you. We said I'm at the dead end. You are free to take it whenever you want. Brick Road. I was also kind of nervous. Well, I was nervous last night that I was going to wake up too late to record this, because I didn't record any Earthbound last night, but I needed to record Earthbound for this morning. Blah, 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 blah. Once a dungeon is built, monsters always start moving in. Brick Road. It was because these monsters are from areas we can't run into, we can't go to anymore, now they have to move in somewhere else. That's hilarious. Is this a dead end, or is this the way forward? That's not actually a treasure block. I don't know, they're easy to get, are usually disappointing. Brick Road. What is this? $5, amazing. Man, you never expect to see that, like, you built a bulletin board without a message. Brick Road. Oh man, here we are, this is the ropes. Okay, I don't want to go there yet. Yeah, I was worried I wasn't going to be able to wake up early enough to record, but that wasn't a problem, because I've been having some nasty nightmares recently. Like, a couple nights ago, I dreamed that, like, we were driving in the car, and way off in the... And, like, we looked in the sky, and, like, a huge meteor came out of the sky and landed, like, 50 miles away on the horizon. And, like, you know, less than 10 seconds later, this, like, huge wave of explosion just obliterated the car and sent us all flying in, like, this blast of just raw, super powerful heat. So that was fun. And then yesterday, I was watching Markiplier's playthrough of Resident Evil 7, and playing Resident Evil 4, so I think because of that... What? Well, you explore that, why don't you make a pit stop? Brick Road. There's somebody in here. I wonder why I'm in this restroom right here. Just who am I? What is life all about? Oh, I'm sorry. Did I make you nervous? I'm not dangerous. Don't worry. Okay. You have a long way to go. Getting some rest and realizing may save you. Yeah. Good night, Bench. May you relax and recover your health and spirits. Let us refresh your body and spirit! Anyway. Yeah. So last night, it was like one big, long dream that I was playing Resident Evil 7. But because I was dreaming, it was like... It wasn't nearly as funny. Because... Oh, I didn't need to heal. I already had all the whoop I needed. I didn't read the sign. There's a useful item at the dead end if you make quite a long walk. Brick Road, yes. Because I was dreaming, it didn't have any of the campy stuff, like the campy voice acting, or like hilarious dialogue, or whatever, you know? So it was just like one big, long, exhausting dream of like survival horror. And at the end, I guess maybe I was in, like, the Ethan must die mode, because there was, like, a bomb. Yeah, another fucking bomb, I know. Well, the meteor wasn't a bomb, but I had a dream about a bomb going off. Ugh. Just thinking about that is making me, like, making me queasy. Another dream I had, like, maybe a week ago now. We were driving in the car, exactly like the meteor dream. And, like, in the distance, I just see this flash. Yes, it was like this flash, and then there was this huge fire on the horizon. And then the fire was just growing. You know? And it just rushed across the horizon. It just rushed down the horizon right to us. And it didn't destroy the car in that dream. We actually kept driving. It wasn't strong enough. It wasn't hot enough to kill us, like, right away. Don't be a slacker. If you work hard, you'll get good stuff. Brick road. I remember thinking right before, as I was flying through the air in the heat in that meteor dream. I couldn't agree more with you, been on the left billboard, brick road. I remember thinking, like, right as I got back to the ground, I was like, oh no. Now, after the wave of wind comes the wave of heat, right? And I'm just gonna get immolated. Like, jeez. Like, give me a break, man. I'm just trying to eat my fish. I have nothing I can throw away. Throw away the Pharaoh's curse. All that does is poison it in me, and I got stuff that does that already. Anyway. You're in a super plush bear, I probably should have thrown away the Viper that was in Tyke's inventory, because I have the snake bag, which also poisons enemies, but the Viper is like, the Viper doesn't have as much unique flavor to it as the Pharaoh's curse. So, yeah, I don't know. But yeah, the first dream was like actually a bomb going off in the background. And we actually managed to, like, drive the car into a nearby town and park on the side of the road before I woke up. And, we didn't die from the heat or anything. Jeez. But, yeah, like, and at the end of the dream last night, there was a bomb in a hedge maze, probably because I was playing Resi 4. There's that hedge maze area with the wolves. And I couldn't prevent it from going off, and then it exploded. But I managed to hide behind a van, so it's like definitely the least lethal, nightmarish ending to a dream, to one of those dreams. You know, considering the first time we didn't die, and then the second time we probably did die. Oh my fuck! Are you serious? All three of those hits missed. I'm gonna use PSI Games Gamma because I don't give two shits. PSI Fire, and you can use a bazooka. A security guard! Anyway. Dude, quit shooting the plush bear, man. Life up, give me a break. Fire gamma! Oh, these guys resist that. A little bit. 93. Oh, it's destroyed already. Well, gee, I wish I hadn't used PSI Games Gamma. That's 40 PP down the drain, especially since it might not even work. Yeah. Ugh! Ugh! I remember I got into an argument. Well, not really an argument. You know, one of those, not angry arguments. Debate, I guess. About whether PSI Rockin' or PK Love was better. The one in Mother 3. And, like, or, like, PSI Starstorm. I think it was actually PSI Starstorm was the other one. It was Rockin' versus Starstorm. It's like, ugh. Rocket in this game is just so unreliable. Like, first of all, it costs, like, way more to use it than PK Love. And second of all, like, it costs a ton to use it. The damage, you know, the damage can be higher, but it can also be way lower than Starstorm. And it might not even work. Because I guess it's like a luck thing? I don't know. I'm not entirely sure what causes it to work or not work. I think it's either luck or speed. Anyway. But yeah, like, I know a lot of... There are a lot... You'll see that happen a lot. Like, PSI Rockin' or whatever you name your PSI favorite thing. Just play not working on an enemy, and you'll be like, wait, what? Okay, the third one is the right one, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. Yep. Here we go. Hello, billboard. This is the second floor of my body, Brick Road. Are we even halfway through this place? What's a dungeon? That is my eternal question. Brick Road. Thank you. Oh, yeah, here we go. We're starting to start running into those winter's enemies now. Yep, Lesser Mook. Oh, Brussels Sprouts. How many times can I say that? Like, I said that, like, four times over the last three episodes of Majora's Mask. I still gotta upload that last episode of Majora's Mask, man. I still have one episode recorded, and I just haven't uploaded it for some reason. Oh, $10. What do you do? Put on a bulletin board, but it's probably unnecessary. Brick Road. Probably. I don't know, man. There's a hole down below. You don't have to worry about this for now. Brick Road. Whatever. There's another bench here. Sure, I'll rest at the bench. May you relax and refresh your body and spirit. Anyway. That is so stupid. Burf waffle. The music in here is so freaking weird, but I love it. But I love it so much. What the hell? Did I have to stay at the bottom? I probably had to go to the lower level here. Yeah. Another bulletin board here. Dude, inside the dungeon, flash photography is prohibited. Oh, no. Okay. I was gonna say, I bet that triggers a photo man spawn, but apparently not. We're standing right around my belly button. Brick Road. That's a bit disturbing. Thanks for sharing. Is there a secret over here? No, it's just a bulletin board. There's an item at the dead end, but I have been known to be wrong occasionally. Sorry. This music is one of my greatest accomplishments. Yeah. I think it's actually, like, sampled from some 80s song. It smells like flowers here. If you can't smell it, your nose must be stuffy. It's not my fault! The gearbox must be faulty! Man, I don't have enough room for whatever's in here. Yeah, a pizza. I don't care what a fucking pizza! I got PSI for healing. I mean, I would love a pizza. Dungeon exploration is tough, but it's also fun. Yeah. Sudden guts pill. Whoa! There's something special over there. I can keep going. Yonorama. Let me tell you something. I did not believe it when I woke up this morning and I went to the bathroom and I saw that it was like it wasn't even 10 o'clock. I was like, what? How the hell could it not be 10 o'clock yet? How is it that I'm carrying so much shit and none of it is, like, something I want to get rid of? The mummy wrap is expendable, but I'm telling you, that stuff is so good. What was even in there? A PSI caramel? Yeah, whatever. There are lots of monsters up there, but don't stress out. Brick Road. This is the third floor of my body. Brick Road. Fascinating. Mad Duck. They can be a nice pet if they stay far away. Like this weird monster museum floor. Oh, the gruff goats. Gruff goat. They are a really gruff kind of goat. Nah! Really? Well, I'm glad you're here to tell us these things. Oh, slimy little piles. He has a bad habit of burping. But then she got mad at me for my burps. I thought she was the nicest girl in the world, but then she got mad at me for my burps. Good job, you finally made it. There is a board upstairs that says that. Brick Road. Yeah, but I want to go down here first. What's in here? A wet towel. What the fuck am I going to do with a wet towel? I mean, I guess I could use it if I get a heat stroke in the desert outside, which actually might happen now that I think about it. Why don't you take a nice little rest here? Well, I just did, but thank you anyway. Alright, let's get to the end of this place. I gotta go check on those fries, man! Those fries! Good job, you finally made it, Brick Road. That face is mine. Feel free to talk to it, Brick Road. Welcome to the Southern Tropical Paradise of Isle Delfino! Long time no see. Mr. Kyle, we met in Winters a long time ago. I'm Brick Road. Dr. Anna has finally made me Dungeon Man. If you want, I'll come with you guys for a while. The return hole is over there. Jump in that hole and then walk out. Alrighty. Return hole, jump in with all your courage, Brick Road. was this hole over here? We can't go there yet, but I'm going to read the sign, because otherwise I'm never going to be able to read the sign ever again. It's going to disappear. Goodbye, exit. Someday you should enter with courage. Brick Road. But not today. Not today.
Not today.
Da-da-da. Burf-wah-wah-wah. What's in here? An IQ capsule? Dude, open the present. You're a Minute Maid or something. Alright. Fish, Kyle, you want to have that? Not Fish. Fish has got plenty of PP already, but Kyle needs to fix those things. I know I just said before that, yeah, you should give your IQ capsules to Fish, not Kyle, but I have since found myself at a deficit of IQ when it comes to repairing my items. Dude! Please don't get a turn. Thank you. Okay. I was saying that to the coffee cup, not any of my party members. That's why that probably didn't make any sense. But anyway. Alright. We should be just about done. Well, yeah, we're here at the entrance. Let's just get out of here. Alrighty. Yeah, we got Dungeon Man on our side! Oh man, do you have any idea how badass Dungeon Man is? Check this shit out. Like, just watch the damage this guy does when he attacks. It's ridiculous. Come on, do it. 464 damage! That's more damage than you can do even at level 99. That is absolutely ridiculous. And I know, because I've grinded up, because I grind up to level 99 often. How the hell are you not dead yet? Yeah, like I'm gonna use PSI on a regular enemy. Fuck that. Not a regular enemy with low defense? No thanks. Gotta watch people coming in and out of the lighthouse. No. Get out of the lighthouse. No thanks, Samuel. Anyway. What? No! Not the photoman. Boys, I can just imagine this guy leaning on that palm tree with one hand while he takes the picture. It's that smug, stylish photo man, like, I'm leaning against this tree, I'm taking your picture. Anyway, let's move on here. Now, this is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, because once you head down south, once you pass through those trees, you lose Dungeon Man forever! And you can never get him back, ever. I actually wonder if you can trigger the same thing happening if you go back into, if you try to go back into the pyramid, if he'll get stuck the same way. You can't fit through the small entrance of the Dungeon Man. Don't you know? You can't fit through the small entrance of the Dungeon Man. Don't you know? Yeah, jeez, man, what the hell is wrong with you? Oh, the guy who wanted to go into Dungeon Man is gone, but the merchant is still here, the mendicant is still here. We're synced up! We're synced. Yeah, get out of my fucking face, man. There's a criminal caterpillar, and I want to fight it. Oh no, the super plush bear! No! Yeah, that's what you get for fucking with my super plush bear, bitch. Oh, then you drop royal iced tea. Oh, that sounds so good. That's so cool. Why do I need to keep chasing after this guy? Oh, thank you for sneaking up on me, actually. Master Criminal Worm! PSI Fire Alpha. Yeah, no big deal. I'm glad we actually get to fight this guy. The other one that I ran into in the Dusty Dunes Desert would have looked like this, but it would have been green. And I was like, GREEN?! Anyway. That's an obscure reference. PSI Fire Alpha again! Not again! Subagob! Not again! Not again! That actually hits Dungeon Man too. I wonder how much health Dungeon Man has. Or if it's even possible for him to die. Yeah, but he's dead. Check out the amount of experience we get from this. This is ridiculous. 27,000 DXP! I'll be honest, I was expecting more than that, but oh well. That was a multiple of 4 level up. That's nice. Boy, Fish didn't even get a level from that. But all right, I think that's good enough. Being able to encounter a criminal caterpillar with Dungeon Man. Ah! Oh no! I am getting caught in the palm trees. I cannot move. Well, if I cannot move, it is okay. Tyke, it makes me sad, but I must say goodbye here at my eternal resting place. Well, that's depressing. Holy shit. What the hell? There's a UFO on the water. Do you see that? What a crazy man. We're gonna end the episode here, actually. In the middle of a fight! Never done that before. Next time on Earthbound, guys, we'll beat this Marauder Octobot. See you then! Bye!